Welcome to this program of Hope Today. May you find blessing and joy as you listen to Word and Music over this next hour. Thank you for joining us. Continuing to discover Jesus in the New Testament Gospel of John, Pastor Tom Cullen will help us see that Jesus is the Good Shepherd. This teaching from John chapter 10 and verses 11 to 21. Have you had a chance to read that passage? Daily study guides and additional resources for today's program and past teaching can be found under the Discovering Jesus icon on the website. That's at L-I-G-H-T, the letter N, the word life.ca. Pastor Tom will be along in the moments ahead. Here first is some time of refreshment as Mac Wigfield leads us to inspirational music. Thank you, Mac.
Thanks for joining me on Hope Today. Gospel music coming up, a song perhaps you know. This is Gold City.
Would you be free from the burden of sin? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Would you or evil a victory win? There's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Oh, would you be whiter, much whiter than snow? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Sin stains are lost in its life-giving flow. There's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood. There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Would you live daily His praises to sing? There's wonderful power in the blood.
Well, there is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb.
Let's take that metaphor of the lamb and turn it around, shall we? Song of personal testimony. From me, actually, but Ivan Parker will sing it for us. I'm the lamb that the shepherd left the flock for.
So many times I strayed away from Jesus. As a lamb that leaves the flock without a care. And the time soon came when I'd gone too far and stumbled. And the more I tried, the more I'd lose my way. I'm the shepherd left the flock for. I was out in the cold all alone. So in need, when Jesus found me, He put His arms around me, and I
I'm back where I belong, and I'm so happy. Oh, I can hear my shepherd's voice all the time, and I'll follow in the path that he may lead me, for the shepherd Jesus is a friend of mine. I'm the lamb that the shepherd left the flock.
But how many times has the shepherd had to go and look for me? Or for you? And that's because sheep tend to stray, even sheep that have been rescued. All we, the prophet says, like sheep have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own way. And the Lord has laid on him. That's the shepherd, folks. The Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. We are, I was going to say lucky, we are. We're blessed to have a loving shepherd and a gracious God. Here are the Kingsmen.
There's a pasture sweet where the shepherd leads, and his sheep never fear to roam. When I'm weak and worn from the rocks and thorns, it is then I am tempted to roam. Lord, I know guiding, guarding, feeding me,
You're listening to Hope Today, and we're discovering the person and work of Jesus Christ as it is described in the Gospel of John. And as you read this New Testament book, you soon see that everyone wants to know who Jesus is. It's a vital question, because how you answer will influence your level of commitment to him. If you think he's merely a nice man, there isn't much incentive to give your life to him. But if you realize that he is the Messiah, the Savior, the Son of God, then he's worthy for you to give your whole life to him. Here's Lianna Klassen with Let All Who Have Breath.
Let all who have breath, all who can see, lift your voices. The wonders you have made, all creation cries with every glance the mystery of your name. God, you are my God, you are my rock and my Savior.
In the New Testament book of John, Jesus says in chapter 10, verse 11, that he is the good shepherd. Now, the original audience certainly has a deeper understanding of this title than we do in our age, but it's not too hard to grasp. For years ago, when the Israelites tried to communicate their understanding of who God was, they would use picture language. They would talk about God as being a fortress, a rock, a shield, and they would look around them and say, "We see God in that." and one of their favorite images for God was a shepherd. So Psalm 23 begins, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." The shepherd was a familiar image to the Israelites because the geography around Palestine lent itself to the raising and herding of sheep. Shepherds and sheep were a constant fixture in the society and culture of ancient Israel. And good shepherds were known for their constant care, their fearless courage, and patient love for their flock. So as the ancient Israelites looked for language and images to describe their God, it's little wonder that they turned to the image of the shepherd. But above all, the name Good Shepherd speaks of relationship. And for this reason, it remains one of my favorites. For as much as we need to know about God's grandeur, as much as we need to recognize his power and authority, as much as we need to realize that the Lord is active and responsible for our salvation, all of that means little if we do not have a relationship with Jesus Christ. He remains distant and cold, a subject for wonderful academic study, but that's all. This name, Good Shepherd, speaks of relationship. Keith Green sings the truth with "The Lord is my shepherd." When Jesus calls himself the Good Shepherd, he's speaking of the relationship between himself and his people. Think of the wonder of this relationship. It is the wonder of a relationship with God himself. That is part of what Jesus is saying. He is saying, I am God in the flesh. All through the Old Testament, God is referred to as the shepherd who cares for the people of Israel. Jacob, David, the prophets Isaiah and Micah all refer to God as their shepherd. So when Jesus says, I am the good shepherd, he's identifying himself as divine. It's tantamount to saying, I am God, the shepherd. And so our relationship with Jesus Christ is one filled with wonder. The wonder of actually being able to relate to the one who set the stars in space and calls them each by name. The wonder of actually belonging to the one who has ownership and authority over all creation. The wonder of it all, that we are actually able to say, I know him, and he knows me. And it is this relationship that is at the heart of Christianity. It's what sets our faith apart from the rest of the world religions. Some people say, all faiths are basically the same. They all teach the same thing. Obey God, do the right thing, treat your neighbor with respect, live at peace with one another, and all will go well with you. No. Christianity is so much more than all of that. It is at its heart the good news that a relationship can now be had with Almighty God, because the Good Shepherd has come in the flesh and has revealed himself to us and called us his own. There's no longer a distance between ourselves and God. Jesus, the Good Shepherd, has bridged it for us. And now we can say, what a friend we have in Jesus. Here are the Reflections Trio.
Forsake thee, take
E. de Graeff, was a Methodist minister and served in some of the denomination's leading churches in the Philadelphia Conference. He was known for his sunny disposition, in spite of the severe testing he experienced throughout life. Our song today is birthed from one of those difficult times in Frank's life, when he stated that his whole attitude had become one of despair and defeat, after being greatly encouraged by 1 Peter 5:7, where he is assured that Jesus cares for him, and by the words written by a fellow hymn writer, Joseph Scrivens, in What a Friend We Have in Jesus, he came out of the experience still trusting in the love and care of Jesus. It is when he turned again to the Lord Jesus in prayer that his faith was strengthened and the words of a new song was born. Of the nearly 200 songs that Frank wrote, our hymn today, Does Jesus Care?, is the only one in the common use today. He later said, "This hymn seems to carry comfort and hope to troubled hearts, and I'm glad I had the inspiration to write it." Do you wonder, like the disciples who with Jesus in a boat during a fierce storm at sea, they came to Jesus and awoke him with this question, "Master, don't you care that we perish?" Be assured today, as then, and as Frank de Graeff recognized in his hymn, "Oh yes, he cares. I know he cares. His heart is touched with my grief." Be comforted as you listen to the Haven Quartet sing, Does Jesus Care?
Does Jesus care when my heart is pained too deeply for mirth and song?
When Jesus says that he is the Good Shepherd, it speaks of the truth that we can now have a relationship with the living God. And we think, how can I possibly have a relationship with the living God? But as we continue reading, we discover that it's possible because Jesus died for you and for me. Jesus says, "I am the Good Shepherd. The Good Shepherd lays down his life for the sheep." The truth that we learn in the Old Testament book of Isaiah is that we all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own way. That is, we've rejected God, we've turned our back on God, and said no to his rule in our lives. And the Lord, Isaiah continues, has laid the price of our sin on Jesus. We are in relationship with Jesus Christ because he's paid the price for us with his own life. And I pray that if you don't know that to be true, your eyes would be open to the fact that we are great sinners who have a great Savior. Because of his willingness to lay down his life for us, we're able to be in relationship with him. But there's more here. And that is the fact that Jesus Christ, as our shepherd, did not lay down his life for us once, but he continually lays down his life for us. You see, it costs Jesus Christ to be our shepherd. Once he bought you and me through his death, it wasn't the end. We are sheep, after all. You go buy yourself a herd of sheep, and do you think that after you've made the purchase, that's the end of it? No, there's the need for constant feeding, constant guidance, endless attention and care. And Jesus, as our good shepherd, does not simply purchase you with his life, but continually gives himself to you, constantly lays down himself for you. Scripture says he is constantly making intercession for us. So, he is the lover of your soul, even unto death. Here's Audrey Assad.
Jesus, the very thought of you, it fills my heart with love. Jesus, you burn like wildfire, and I am overcome. Lover of my soul, even unto death, with my every breath, I will love you. Lover of my soul, even unto death, with my every breath, I will love you. Jesus, you are my
Jesus says that he is the good shepherd who lays down his life for the sheep. How different he is from the hired hand that he speaks of in John chapter 10. Philip Keller, in his book entitled A Shepherd Looks at Psalm 23, tells of how on a ranch next to his, there was a herd of sheep that was kept by a hired man. and he was the most indifferent manager he had ever met. He was not concerned about the condition of his sheep at all, as the sheep were left to forage for themselves. They had poor water to drink and hence were a diseased, pathetic-looking flock. To their distress, the selfish owner seemed utterly callous and indifferent. What if a sheep wanted green grass, fresh water, shade, safety, or shelter from the storms? What if they wanted relief from wounds, bruises, disease, and parasites? He ignored their needs. He couldn't care less. Why should he? They were just sheep, fit only for the slaughterhouse. And Philip Keller writes, "I never looked at those poor sheep without an acute awareness that this is a precise picture of those wretched old taskmasters, sin and Satan on their derelict ranch, scoffing at the plight of those within their power." Is there a habit you need help to overcome? Is there an anxiety that you are facing? Is there a difficulty at work or at home? My friends, you and I have a good shepherd who has purchased us, and now through faith, we are his. And like a shepherd cares for his sheep, so Jesus cares for you. Give him that habit. Give him that anxiety. Give him that difficulty. Go to him in prayer. You have a relationship with him, and he knows you and seeks to care for you. He lays down his life for you. He's the good Shepherd. So Paul Turner and Steve Green sing, "Jesus My Strength."
When fields become fallow, though vineyards lay bare, and famine like winter turns hope to despair, still will I trust you, still will I say, Jesus my refuge, Jesus my strength. When mountains of sadness leave valleys of fear, and rivers of heartache fill oceans of tears, still will I trust you, still will I say, Jesus my comfort, Jesus my strength. When trees lose their bloom, when dying years whisper the dreams of my youth, still will I trust you, still will I say, Jesus my promise, Jesus my strength. Of death descend on me, I rest in hands of peace. There will I praise you, there will I say, there will I praise. My rescue, Jesus, Jesus.
I'm so glad you've chosen to listen to Hope today as we glorify God together with Magnificat.
My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit exalts in God my Savior, for He has loved with mercy on my name will be forever exalted. For the mighty God has done great things for me, and His mercies will reach from age to age. And
Jesus says that He is the good shepherd who lays down His life for His sheep. That speaks of His great love for you. There are many listening today who doubt that God loves them. And I believe that one of our problems is that we think we have to prove ourselves to God before He'll love us. But there's nowhere in Scripture that says that we have to earn Christ's love. I'm not a farmer, but I know I'm not wrong here. If Christ is your shepherd, does that make you an ox? Does that make you a cow? No, if Christ is your shepherd, that makes you a sheep. And do you know what sheep do? Nothing. They grow a covering of wool, but that's it. They aren't like cows who give milk twice a day. They aren't like oxen that pull a plow. Sheep do nothing, and yet the shepherd cares for them and tends them. Oh, how I pray that you would take this in. There are so many who have this half-baked faith that is filled with obedience to God but lacks any awareness of His love. So instead of acting like sheep, you're acting like an ox, working all the time, trying to prove yourself to God. If you want to escape this idea of trying to prove yourself to God, you need to know that He is your shepherd who loves you. How do I know? Because He lays down His life for you. And you're only a sheep who can produce nothing. That's love. Here's Chalsea Amber with Waters May Rise.
Though the rains fall and the floods rise.
In all of life, be assured that Jesus, our Good Shepherd, really cares. I know my Savior cares. Please go to lightandlife.ca, where you will find the study guide for our next program and additional teaching. That is L-I-G-H-T, the letter N, the word life.ca. Before we are together next, you will find it helpful to read John chapter 11 and verses 1 to 16. You may want to hear this program or a previous one again, or you may want to share a program with a friend. You can do all that by visiting www.lightandlife.ca. Through the website, you can also send Pastor Tom and our team a note. We would love to hear from you. Hope Today is produced at Straight Path Studio. We look forward to being with you and your friends next time for another program of hope. Until then, keep looking ahead. Jesus is coming again.